Okay, I think the sounds are good and we are okay. Okay, so this afternoon, okay, I'm going to wait for a little bit. Okay, so para maghintay po for those that who sign up for the Zoom session. Okay, for those that are watching this on the PAM Academy page, then thank you so much. Thank you for being with me this afternoon. Okay, to be honest, no, I keep doing this session kasi I believe that year 2021 will be a year of prosperity and abundance. Actually, yesterday, I attended an event with PICPA and there's this one word generator, okay? And then you will have your theme for the year, okay? And then when I look at it, you know, the word that I got is enrich, okay? So, but before this event, actually, I already have in mind what will be my theme for year 2021. And that is prosperity and abundance. And then it was reinforced by the word enrich. Okay, so ang gusto ko is actually ngayong year 2021, not only personally, but I want also to enrich the life of many Filipinos around the world, or probably OFWs, and yung mga working professionals as well. Alam mo yun, Filipinos na naapektuhan ng pandemic, because we know that there are so many Filipinos na they lost their jobs, they suffered from unpaid leave, or they also suffered from the Typhoon Rolly and that Typhoon Ulysses. Ang daming nangyari. Ako personally, my life was changed by the pandemic. And even if, alam mo yun, kahit isang tao lang yung maniwala dun sa sinishare ko, I'll be more than happy, you know, kasi my goal is to really spread kindness and love. Okay, so yun yung goal ko for this year. Okay, just let me check if everything is okay, then I'll go through with my PowerPoint presentation. So if you are attending this live, what I really want you to do is be interactive with the Zoom and share. Okay, if I ask you to participate or I'm asking a question, then please participate with it. And if you have any questions, you can directly send it to me, or for those that are watching this live on Facebook, then it will be good if I could check it later with the comment section. Okay, so let me just have some checking for my technicalities. Okay, so I think everything is working fine. Okay, so I will go through, okay, with the sessions, and then we'll start. Okay. Okay, so a little bit of background. Okay, so for those that are watching this, okay, I'm a founder or blogger of PAM Academy. Okay, why PAM? They keep asking this. Planning, Actions, and Mindset Academy. So this is my strategy in life, which I called on the acronym PAM. Planning, you need to do your plan, and then you need to take actions from the plan, and then you need to have the right mindset. Okay, there's this book by Ulysses Espartero. I was one of the influential expats or Filipinos in the UAE in year 2018. Okay, so it's me here in the photo. And then I'm affiliated with CPA Dreams. Okay, they called me as CPA Dreams Coach. So I'm helping those CPA aspirants to achieve their CPA dreams. And I'm a CPARMI Review Director. This is a Center for Professional Advancement and Review in the Middle East. So one of the best review center in terms of CPA and USCMA. So I'm affiliated with those. But more than anything else, I am a father of two. Okay, so ito yung kids ko. Actually, this picture is a little bit old. Okay, so this is just during Father's Day. Okay, this is one thing that I'm proud of. You know, when you are receiving message from your wife and from your kids that you are the best dad, and that's me. Okay, and God is so gracious sa family na meron ako kasi we are able to spend together quality time. Like today, we're able to go to Creek Park, no? Nagpakain kami ng birds, naglaro kami ng scooter, nag-maze. There are so many things. And that's what I'm proud of. Okay? So more than anything else. Now, why we are working hard? Okay, this is a question. Kung ikaw ay professionals or ikaw is working right now, then probably you should ask yourself why you are really working hard. Okay? Siguro possibility is for career promotion, career ladder. You are the breadwinner of the family, so you want to support your family. So, third is probably you want to have an early retirement. Okay, and our topic today, financial freedom and richness. Okay, yan yung mga reasons why we are working hard. Okay, possible yan. Yan yung mga usually when I do workshop, events, and trainings, those are the five reasons na nakukuha ko why we are working hard. Now, for OFWs naman, why we are working abroad. So, it's same story, okay? Higher income, you want to support the family, early retirement, financial freedom, and richness. Okay, so yan yung kalimitang reasons why we leave our country. Kung hindi mo nalalaman o naiintindihan why you really left the country, this is the time for you for year 2021, why I'm really working abroad or why I'm working hard. So those are the five reasons. And my focus, okay, in this session is about financial freedom. Don't worry, I don't have any products or I will do any promotions or marketing for anything. This is just a pure financial literacy session, okay? Now, let's move on. Okay, if you are an OFW, okay, so kalimitan is, ina-ask natin, what is the meaning of OFW? Okay, diba, overseas Filipino workers. But the truth is, we are overspending Filipino workers. Okay, we should not overspend. Okay, actually, these words are borrowed from Kabayan Rico. Okay, he's always using this, so I'm borrowing from him. Oversending Filipino workers. Okay, we kept sending money to our home country because you are the breadwinner and probably hindi mo kasama yung pamilya mo. So ang pinaka way para ikaw ay magkaroon ng, alam mo yung gano'n, ng mawala yung guilt sa atin, sa sarili natin every time na magkakaroon tayo ng chance na mag-send ng pera, okay, sa family natin, ang ginagawa natin is, ayan yun, anong tawag doon? Mag-send ng remittance sa family natin. Now, another meaning ng OFW is overwork Filipino workers. Okay, let's face it, totoo naman talaga na ang mga Pilipino is overwork. Okay, nangyayari yan, di ba? Talagang totoo na tayo ay mga overwork. Okay, overworked sa trabaho and minsan underpaid. But the truth is, some of our families in the Philippines, they don't know about it. Kasi ang nakikita nila lang sa Facebook post mo, nakikita nila sa Instagram, are those nice pictures with the nice background. No, pagandahan tayo ng mga photos. But these are the truth behind the meaning of OFW. We are overspending. No, kasi tumaas yung income mo, tumaas din yung lifestyle. Okay, oversending Filipino workers. Pagka nangangailangan ng pera, of course, minsan dinadagdagan pa natin. Tayo ang nagpapaaral sa mga pinsan natin, hanggang sa pati kapitbahay, pinag-aral mo na rin. Okay, overwork. Anong nangyayari? Sometimes overseas Filipino workers are coming back home para magpagamot. Alam mo yung ganon. Ako nakita ko yan personally. So I hope this meaning of OFW will be changed. After this session, I'm giving you the ladder. Okay, kung ano yung pwede nating gawin. I'm personally joining to financial freedom. And I'm not hiding that I would not say that I'm already financially free. It's not. I'm not. And I'm joining with it. And I want you to join with me. Now, money culture problems. Okay? Yung mga Pilipino, meron tayong money culture problems. Ano yung mga money culture problem natin? Yung manana habits. Okay, mamaya na lang. Okay? Pagka may mga importanteng bagay na kailangan nating tapusin, pinagpapaliban o pinagpapabukas natin. I'll give you an example. For example, sa savings. Okay? Noong time na may work ka pa, you didn't even bother to save a single peso para sa sarili mo. And then the time comes, dumating ang pandemic, you are terminated from the job and you need to go back home, wala kang naipon. Okay, and that is a very sad story. Okay, I heard a lot of this story, so this is from my own experience as well. Ningas kugon. Okay, pag umalis ka ng Pilipinas, no, ano nangyayari? Okay, masipag tayo sa umpisa. Okay, anong ginagawa natin? Binabayaran natin lahat ng utang na nagastos natin para mag-abroad. But then later, once you already paid it out, ang next thing na mangyayari is, since nabayaran ko na, para naman sa sarili ko. And then you started overspending naman. Okay? Dapat, you keep doing the things na pwede kang mag-succeed in your personal finance after mong mabayaran lahat ng naging utang mo. Dapat ganun. Hindi lang tayo magaling sa umpisa. Dapat tapusin natin yung journey na yon. If you are an OFW that one day are planning to go back home, then this is the time for you to start. Then sandwich generations. Ano nangyayari? Paulit-ulit lang. Okay? Probably ang naging sitwasyon is yung magulang mo nag-abroad, then ikaw naman ang mag-abroad, you support your parents, and then ganun din, susuportahan mo rin yung parents mo. And then later, ikaw naman yung magdidepend sa mga anak mo. Ang nangyayari is investing on the next generation. But we need to invest on our own para hindi na tayo umasa. Okay? Hindi po masama ang tumulong. Pero paano mo tutulungan ng iba kung ang sarili mo hindi mo kayang tulungan? Okay? Then, YOLO. This is very popular right now, especially for those millennial. Okay? You only live once. Okay? I agree. And we don't want to have a regrets. No? We don't want one day na magre-regrets tayo kasi hindi natin na-maximize yung time natin abroad. Okay? Hindi ka nakapunta sa mga magagandang pasyalan na dapat naranasan mo. Well, you can do it if you already set aside for your financial future. Okay? Wala ka ng problema once you go back home. So, yun na yung time na possibility na pwede ka nang magsabi na YOLO. Okay? Now, let's move on. Now, think about, I'm going to give you 100 million pesos. What you gonna do with it? Okay? So siguro, let's do this activity. If I'm going to give you 100 million pesos right now, what you gonna do? Okay? So let's check it. What you gonna do with 100 million pesos? Okay, during the trainings and seminars na ginagawa ko, laging sinasabi nila is, okay, I'm going to travel. Okay, I'm going to travel around the world with this money. I'm going to buy a house for my family. I'm going to give to the poor. I'm going to do the charity. Okay, so I will go back home if you are an OFW. I don't need to work. I will put up my business. I will. Okay? So, ngayon, to be honest, those answer is valid. Okay? But you know, what I noticed from the answers, the main reason, okay, now why you need or why you want 100 million pesos is because you want to be financially free. You can do the things that you want without any financial worries. Okay, so ganun yung nangyayari. And siguro this is the time that you need to check with yourself. What I really want to do to achieve my million pesos goal. Okay, and with that, ito yung session natin na financial freedom lover. You might not won the lottery, okay? Kasi laging ang ginagawa ng mga Pilipinos, ang haba-haba ng pila para kumuha ng PCSO ticket or sa big ticket dito sa UAE. But the chance is very, very, very minimal. Okay? And sometimes those winners, then later, they gonna go bankrupt. Okay? Why? Because they don't have the right knowledge and right information. And this is the reason why I'm sharing this. Okay? Like what I have said, I'm sharing this because I really want to spread the knowledge, the kindness, and the love that you could have through handling your personal finance. Now, let's move on. Do you want to achieve financial freedom? Okay, so laging yan yung question. Okay, and of course, sino ba naman ang ayaw niyan? Okay, so everybody will answer it yes. Okay, then what we need to do here is start moving in the ladder to financial freedom or what I call financial freedom ladder. Okay, but the important part here is self-awareness. What I will ask you is answer the following questions. From these questions, dito manggagaling yung financial freedom ladder. Okay? And this session is not about me. Yes, maybe 20% is about me because I want to learn as well and I want to share. But this process is your process for you to ask yourself or do your self-reflection. Now, these are the questions. What is your money mindset? Okay? Again, siguro gas-gas na yung money mindset na yan. Okay? But let me just go back and explain it. Okay? Why we need to have a right money mindset. Another question you need to ask yourself is, where do you stand right now? Asa saan ka ba ngayon? When you go abroad, did you notice what are the changes that happened to you in your finances? Nagkaroon ka ba ng malaking bahay o nagkaroon ka ng maraming utang? Naging maayos ba ang pamilya mo o nangaliwa ang asawa mo? Naging mahal ka ba ng mga anak mo o minahal nila ang mga package, ang mga balikbayan boxes? So you need to ask yourself. You need to have a self-awareness process. Where do you really stand right now? Then, where do you want to go? Okay? But of course, bago ka pumunta sa pupuntahan mo, kailangan alam mo kung nasasaan ka ngayon. Example, 'di ba sa Google Maps, pag naghahanap ka ng isang location, ilalagay mo muna yung your location. And then, ilalagay mo ang destination. So, what we are doing here on this financial freedom ladder is to know where we stand right now and where we want to go. Okay? So we will answer those questions one by one. And I want you to do it later by yourself. Okay? Now, let's move on. So first is, I'm going to discuss what is the right money mindset. Okay? Now, this is the money mindsetting process. Kanina, when I asked you, what you gonna do with 100 million pesos? Okay? Probably, most of the answers na na-receive, travel, do this, do that, no? Is because you have already a mindset about money. Okay? Kung lahat ng sinabi mo is about pleasure, probably kasi hindi mo naranasan ang pleasure with using money. Okay? Ang kung gusto mo is magtayo ng sarili mong charity, probably you are not able to help because you are lacking money as well. Okay? So this is the process. This is what we know actually. Money is the root of all evils. Money is not that important. Money can't buy happiness. Now, what I want you to do is go back in time or in your past that you are hearing your parents talking about lacking money. Okay? Ako personally, to be honest with you, no, if I will go to the past, my parents, no, nagbibigay sila ng allowance for the whole week. Okay? So during that time, it's 100 pesos. No, nung high school, meron kang 100 pesos per day, okay, na allowance, and then ibabudget mo yon kasama na lahat. And merong time na kasi piyesta, pumunta ako sa color game. Alam mo yung ganun, nagko-color game ako, which is, okay, gambling. Okay, when I go back, actually, this is the reason why I keep gambling on high-risk investments. And I'm losing them. Okay, nakita ko sa Pasko, okay, probably the reason is kasi meron gambling background. And of course, my tatay as well, he really loves sabong. Alam mo yun, nagsasabong ng manok. Okay, and every time na mananalo si tatay, uuwi siya, magdala-dala is punong-puno yung sasakyan niya ng groceries. Alam mo yung ganun, one time, big time din pag nananalo. But see, we need to heal it and we need to move on and replace our money mindset. Okay? So, replace your money mindset. How we gonna do it? I want you to check your wallet right now. Okay? Paki-check ng wallet mo. How did you arrange your money inside your wallet? Okay? Nakatupi ba siya ng maayos? Is it properly arranged? Is it properly put inside? Alam mo yun, maayos ba yung pagkakalagay sa wallet mo ng pera mo or even your cards? O punong-puno, sobrang laki ng wallet mo kasi you have a lot of receipts. Okay, ang daming resibo. To be honest with you, okay, if you don't treat your money, okay, literally, okay, kung hindi mo naayos yung pera mo kahit dun sa wallet mo, then how can you replace your money mindset? Okay? So, I want you to do it and check your wallet. And from now on, treat the money as a tool or as a way, okay, kung paano mo i-handle yung money mindset mo. Okay? Well, to be honest, now is digital na tayo. Okay? So, most of us are using cards. Or even we do PayPal. Okay, lahat is digital. So digital money. Ang laman na lang ng wallet, probably is cards. Okay, but we need to treat it as we replace our money mindset. Okay, now let's move on. So how you gonna replace it? Money is very important. Again, like what I have said, money is only a tool. It is a great facilitator. What does it mean? Okay, bakit sinabi ko siyang important? Because money can pay your bills. Money can buy your dream car. Money can buy your dream house. You can donate to charities. You can give to the poor. Diba? Eh kung ikaw, you don't have money, then all these things will come and you will have a problem. And you will not be able to have a peace of mind to sleep at night. Okay, minsan nawawala yung peace of mind pag natutulog ka kasi baka bukas maputol na yung utilities mo o baka bukas, baka next month you cannot pay your bills, your credit card debts, no? O baka nandiyan na yung collector later. Okay? So, learn how to be a master of money but not slaves to it. Actually, in the Bible, what they really mention there is the love of money, okay, which is the root of all evil, not the money itself. Because money will only have a power when someone holds it. Ang power po ay nasa taong humahawak ng pera. You are the one who's giving the power to money. Again, consider money only as a tool. Money is a great facilitator so that you can pay your bills, you can buy your dream car, you can buy your dream house, you can donate to charities, and you can give to the poor. Now, once we already do the self-awareness process with our money mindset, the next step will be, where do you stand? Nasa saan ka ba ngayon, kapatid? Then again, I will explain and expand, where do you want to go? Now, where do you stand in your financial situation? In my previous blog, I asked you to do some financial checking. Okay, parang yung katulad ng health. Kumukonsult tayo sa doctor. Okay, and then the doctor will give you the prescription. Now, sometimes our mistake, we consult our neighbors, we consult someone that we just met, no, or financial advisors, no. Dapat lumalapit po tayo, tumihingi tayo ng advice sa mga taong they already achieve financial freedom, or if it's regarding to business, you need to go to the someone who is successful already in the business area. Okay, ganun din sa finance. Kaya marami pong nai-scam kasi mabilis tayong maniwala. Kahit kapibahay mo, papaniwalaan mo. Ang return nito is 100% in after 6 months. Then, yun po yung nagiging dahilan kung bakit tayo nai-scam. Now, what I want you to do is check how much you own. Okay? Pag sinabi po, ano yung mga pagmamay-ari mo right now? And that is called your assets. Okay? Pag sinabing how much you own, this includes the cash that you have, okay, physically, the cash that you have in the bank, the receivables, yung mga pinautang mo, the cars, the house and lot, everything that you own, okay, nakapangalan sa'yo. That is what you call asset. And then, how much you owe. Ito naman po, dito papasok yung utang. Probably, ito yung credit card debts. Ito yung mortgage on the bank. Ito yung personal loans, consumer loans, car loans, house loan, or condominium loans, pag-ibig loans. So, lahat po ng pagkakautang mo. So, assets minus liabilities equals net worth. Now, how much you own less how much you owe. Ibig sabihin, ano yung pagmamay-ari mo, ililess mo yung pagkakautang mo. And then, you will have your net worth. Okay, this is very popular to politicians, right? And this is what they call SALN, Statement of Assets, Liabilities, and Net Worth. Now, I'm suggesting you do it yourself. Okay? Ngayon, alam mo na kung ano yung na-own mo, alaman ng pera mo sa bangko, ang hawak mong pera ngayon, ang mga receivables mo, ang pagmamay-ari mo. Then, ililess mo lang lahat ng pagkakautang mo. Now, an example of SALN, eto po siya. Negative SALN. Okay? So, ganito yung pagkakakalculate. Yung cash on hand niya, 5,000 pesos. Meron siyang savings, 10,000. Wala siyang investments. Pinautang niya yung kapatid niya, 2,000. Ang total assets niya is 17,000. Now, ang liabilities naman niya. Meron siyang credit card debts, which is 50,000 pesos. Then, meron siyang personal loans, 120,000 pesos. Accounts payable, yung kapitbahay or nangutang siya sa sari-sari store, 180,000 pesos. Then, the net worth is 163,000. Okay, anong ibig sabihin niyan? So, negative 163,000. Mas malaki yung liabilities compared to your assets. Okay, so I want you to do this activity after this session and check what you really have, okay, and what you really owe, okay? Kailangan mong malaman kung nasa saan ka right now. Again, yung question natin is, where do you stand right now? Okay, you will never know where you want to go kung hindi mo po siya i-check. Now, let's move on. Push yourself to have a positive SALN. Okay? Kailangan po magkaroon ka ng positive statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth. So that is one reason why we need to know the financial freedom ladder. Diyan po tayo mag-uumpisa. Kung negative ang saldo mo, unti-unti tayong aakyat sa financial freedom ladder. Okay? Now, let's go back sa self-awareness process. Okay? Now, in-answer na natin yung what is your money mindset? Where do you stand? Alam mo na yan right now. Okay? Then, the next question will be, where do you want to go? Ito na yon. Saan tayo pupunta? Okay? So, dito na papasok yung financial freedom ladder. Kasi ang gusto naman natin is magkaroon ng financial freedom. Correct? But again, I will say, gas-gas na yung financial freedom. Kaya kukonti lang ang interested sa mga financial literacy. Okay? And sometimes, the thinking is, mahirap i-achieve yun. Kaya hindi ko na lang susubukan. Okay? But I want to share with you yung steps ko po. Like what I have said, I'm taking the step-by-step process. Okay? Now, this is the financial freedom ladder. Okay? So, yan po yung sinasabi nating financial freedom ladder. Okay? Ang first ladder natin is yung nasa baba ka pa lang. Okay? Eliminating liabilities. Okay? So, eliminating liabilities, katulad ng sabi ko, kung negative ang net worth mo o yung statement of assets and liabilities, no? Negative yan. So, we need to make it positive. So, ang first step is we need to eliminate liabilities. Okay? I will expand on the ladder. Okay? But I will just show you what are those. Okay? Next, save for emergency funds. I'm going to explain. Kailangan ba talaga natin ng emergency funds? And how many months? Then, start protecting yourself. If you are a breadwinner, then you need to protect yourself. Even if you are not the breadwinner, kung meron kang family, okay, then you really need to protect. Building passive income. Ito, this is favorite. Okay? Kasi nga naman, passive income is earning money while you are at sleep. What I want to do here is show you some of the passive income sources. Okay? Then, accumulating good assets. Okay? Ibig sabihin, dito na papasok yung building wealth. Okay? Then, the last ladder will be the financial freedom. Okay? Sino ba naman yung ayaw na uuwi ka na ng Pilipinas and you don't have any financial worries? Or if you are working in a corporate world, you are going to escape the 9-to-5 job. Okay? So, yan po yon. Again, the question here is, pwede ba akong mag-skip ng step? I highly recommend that you go through a step-by-step process. Okay? Kung meron kang liabilities, probably mataas yung mga interest niyan. Kaya bago ka mag-jump sa other steps, you fix muna yung first ladder. Okay? Now, let's go on and expand it. Eliminating liabilities. So like what I have said, this is the first step. Okay? Probably you have a credit card. Okay? You have a credit card debts. Okay? What I want you to do after this session, go and check, no? Paki-check po ng statement mo ng credit card. Kasi ang possibility is hindi mo pinapansin yung interest and other charges. Okay? Yung interest and other charges po, mataas po yan. And then may annual fees pa yan. So, what you really need to do is if you are not disciplined and you are only paying the minimum amount, then what you need to do is cut your credit card. Now, maaaring meron kang mga personal loans or mortgages or mga bad debts na tinatawag. What I want you to do is check if meron ba talagang cash flows na nangyayari dun sa loans na yon. Of course, kung ito ay consumer loans, okay, automatically, this is what we call bad debts. Doon naman sa mga naka-loan ang condominium, ang house, okay, or nagpaparent. Ang sinasabi kasi ng mga real estate agent lagi, go, take this unit kasi bangko na lang ang magbabayad. Well, to be honest with you, this is not always the case, okay? The possibility is ang labanan sa market dahil lalo na ngayon, maraming nawala ng work. Marami ang hindi nakakabayad ng renta. Marami ang hindi nakakabayad ng amortization. Now, kung sa tingin mo, bad debts na siya, kung sa tingin mo is hindi na nakakapagdala ng cash flows, then what you need to do is eliminate that liabilities. Okay? Mahirap din pong matulog sa gabi kung marami kang pinagkakautangan. Okay? So that is eliminating bad debts. Now, in terms of credit card, kung ang binabayaran mo lang is yung minimum, okay, hindi ka nagbabayad on time. Okay? Ako po personally, I will show you what I did. This. I cut my credit cards literally. Okay? And you know what I did? I put these credit cards in my piggy bank. Nilagay ko po siya dito. Kinuha ko lang ulit. Binuksan ko na siya actually. Okay? So, hindi ko na siya nagagamit ngayon. Now, I totally fully paid my credit cards. Okay. To be honest then, I'm a disciplined person. Okay? Kaso sometimes, pagka merong unexpected, I keep spending. Kasi, okay, parang nasa sa isip ko, I'm going to redeem the points. And I did it. I'm having like 1 week grocery redemption from the credit card. Okay? But then, when I noticed na hindi ko pala binabayaran ng full, then I cut it. And now, I'm fully free from the credit card debts. Okay? So, sa mga hindi po discipline, do it. Okay? Now, let's move on. Let me just go back again. Now, build emergency funds. This is the next ladder. Okay? Ito po is save for emergency funds. Okay? This is more than true. Walang naniniwala na kailangan nating mag-save for any emergency. When COVID-19 pandemic started, then what happened? Kinailangan mo ng emergency funds. Probably, kung merong nagkasakit sa pamilya, okay? Kung merong nagkasakit sa pamilya, the problem will be if you don't have any funds, then paano ka makakapagpaga mo? Okay? Ang equivalent po nito is 6 to 9 months salary. Okay? 6 to 9 months salary ang dapat mong ipunin. Okay? So for example, you have 10,000 pesos salary, so that means you have 16,000 pesos emergency funds. Okay? And then, kung ang funds na hawak mo naman is nasa, kung ang earnings mo naman is mas, nasa 20,000, so that means you need to have at least 120,000 in your bank. Okay? So actually, okay, 120,000 for 10 months. Okay? For 12,000 pesos naman. Okay? So ikaw na ang bahalang mag-calculate. Okay? Now, usually po, anong ginagawa natin? Ako personally, what I'm doing is, I'm using po yung, eto. Eto ang ginagamit ko. Okay? Meron po ako nito. Actually, etong piggy bank, okay? Gumagamit ako ng piggy bank, to be honest. Okay? Just to show you. Okay. Now, after the 6 to 9 month salary, okay, you already save for your emergency, then it's good. You can sleep at night kasi any emergency that will come, you are safe for the next 6 to 9 months. Even if you lost your job, even if mawalan ka ng trabaho o magkaroon ng cuts or unpaid leave or dumating pa ang pandemic at hindi ka makapag-work, then you don't need to worry for the next 6 months to 9 months. Now, bakit kailangan 6 to 9 months? No? Okay, kasi yan yung time Okay, if you lost your job, then you have so much time to find a new one. Within the 6 months to 9 months period, probably you already know what job you're gonna take. Okay, next, protecting the breadwinner. Okay, so ito yung sinasabi natin, start protecting yourself. Okay, ako personally, this happened to me in the past. Okay, nangyari na po to sa akin personally. I will share with you a story. Okay, why you need to protect the breadwinner. Okay, kasi this will be the life insurance, health insurance, disability, or critical illness. Okay, ako po personally, what I'm doing right now, I have a life insurance. My wife is a full-time housewife, and then I have two kids. So that means I'm the breadwinner. Ako lang po ang source of income. Okay, so I have a life insurance. Anything that will happen to me, they will be covered. Okay, paano kinakalculate yung life insurance? Okay, so tingnan mo yung needs mo. Pag nawala ka na, okay, ano yung mga magagastos ng asawa mo or ng pamilya mo para sa'yo? Okay, kung member ka ng OWA, then ang OWA will take care of expatriation ng remains. Okay, so pwede mo nang ilas yan kung meron kang OWA sa magagastos. Second is, kung walang work si Mrs., okay, at ikaw din ang nagpapaaral sa mga bata, then you need to calculate 12 months necessary expenses nila. Why? Kasi yung family mo is mag-undergo ng grieving. Okay? Ibig sabihin, wala pa yan sa sarili nila pag nawala ka. Okay? So, kailangan yung finances is in place. Kasi mahihirapan yung misis mo o yung pamilya mo pagka nawala ka na. Eh kung protected sila for the next 6 months or for the next 1 year or 2 years yung education ng bata is covered, then you don't need to worry for their future pag nawala ka na. Now, this is highly recommended if you are the breadwinner. Kung ikaw ay single, then probably you don't need the life insurance yet. Okay, another important part will be the health insurance. Okay, ibig sabihin ng health insurance, this should cover your critical illness. Hindi lang yon, okay? Dapat kasama dito yung maternity ni Mrs. Okay? Lahat ng possible expenses, like for example, COVID-19. Did you notice, nakita ko nga eh, may mga artista, okay, na nag-undergo ng COVID-19, they got COVID-19. Like for example, narinig ko kay wife, si Donita Knows. Okay? Humingi ng tulong din kay Tulpo or tinulungan ni Tulpo. Umabot ang bills around 600,000 pesos. Now, can you imagine if you don't have the health insurance and if this happens to you, then it's going to be a big problem. Malaking problema. Malulubog sa utang ang pamilya mo. Okay? Now, ako personally, okay, si Mrs. dun sa pangalawang baby namin, okay, the good thing is that time I'm changing job. Okay? Meron naman si Mrs. na health insurance for maternity. But after that, no, dahil pinanganak niya yung baby two weeks early, no, kinailangan ibalik yung bata dun sa ospital and mag-undergo ng incubator. Okay? Now, to be honest with you, hindi na siya covered ng insurance. So what happened is, this is the time actually that I was got into debts kasi I'm on exit and kailangan ding bayaran yung hospital. And ang hiningin deposit is around 5,000 dirhams. Okay, so that's a lot of money when you convert it in peso. But can you imagine yung ganong sitwasyon if it will happen to you and you don't have any health insurance, especially in the Philippines, then you will be broke and you will get into debts. Ganon yung nangyayari sa maraming Pilipino. If you are in the UAE na responsibility ng company for you to have a health insurance, then you are lucky. But some employers, they are not covering everything. And you always have a co-payment. So you really need to have it. Disability and critical illness, when you get old, those are very important aspects as well. Okay? Now, so alam mo na, so I'm not selling any of this, okay? What I want you to do is do your own research. If you need a financial advisor, then choose really a good one, okay? Next, building passive income, okay? Dito tayo sa building passive income, okay? Pag sinabing passive income, favorite to ng mga Pilipino. Okay, kaya ang daming nai-scam because for this reason, pag sinabing passive, ibig sabihin hindi mo na kailangan talaga magtrabaho. Okay? And then kahit natutulog lang, go go go, may papasok pa rin pera. Ayun yung kalimitang sinasabi. Okay, I will be honest with you, okay? Hindi lahat ng passive is hindi lahat ng passive income is madaling kunin. You need to build it. Okay? This is the reason. Okay, building passive income is after the steps. You already protected. You have your emergency funds. You don't have any extra debts. Pwede ka nang mag-build ng passive income probably for the reason that you have already extra cash flows. Okay, ginagawa to pag meron ka na talagang cash flows and ginawa mo na lahat ng steps. Okay, but before I go through with the building of passive income, okay, paano kung wala kang extra? How to increase your cash flows? Okay, mga reasons, no, o mga possibility na what you can do in increasing your cash flows. First is, if you did not get any salary increase for the last 3 years, then start negotiating with your company. Okay? Meaning, humingi ka ng increase kung more than 3 years na wala ka pa rin nare-receive. Second is, check if there's any possible company promotions so your cash flows will increase. Third, is there an opportunity for you to do some side hustle? Kung meron kang free time, okay, let's say natatapos ang work mo at 5 o'clock, then you are single and you don't have any responsibility at home, then probably from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock ng gabi, you can do a side hustle. Okay, maraming gumagawa niyan. Fourth possibility is do or start a business. I will go and expand with it, but I put the startup business on the part of accumulating good assets. Okay? Now, dito sa building passive income, andi dito rin yung mga investments. So dito ko nilagay yung mga possible investments na pwede mong gawin. Tinatawag ko talaga siyang passive kasi you don't need anything na ikaw personally ang gagawa nun. Okay, like for example, mutual funds. Ano ba yung mutual funds? A mutual funds is a pool of funds managed by fund managers. Ibig sabihin, naglalagay ka ng pera monthly or one time, so depende sa capability mo, sa extra funds mo, sa extra money mo, then nagmamanage is ang fund manager. So that is 100% passive. Why? Kasi nilagay mo lang yung pera mo doon. Another example is Pag-ibig MP2. Okay? This is a government pag-ibig program. Yung pinaka-normal na binabayaran mo is tinatawag na Pag-ibig MP1 or yung regular contribution. Yung Pag-ibig MP2, this is where you are going to receive a dividends yearly. And mataas ang rate, 6% to 7.5% for the last years, no, yung mga nakaraang taon. Ibig sabihin, maglagay ka lang ng pera mo, wala ka nang gagawin, you will just receive your dividends. Bonds, ganun din. May mga treasury bonds, private bonds, government bonds, companies bonds na meron ka ng fixed return na marireceive. Okay? So, wala ka na talagang gagawin. Stocks, okay? To be honest, when you say passive in the stock market, that means you are investing. This doesn't include trading. So don't tell to me or don't say to anyone, invest in the stock market or trade in the stock market and then kikita ka na. Okay, that is not true. Okay, kung ikaw ay investing, you need also to get the right company. Okay, hindi ibig sabihin, pag naglagay ka is 100%, you will be a winner na makaka-receive ng passive income. Though, most of the index stocks, yung malalaking company like Jollibee Food Corporation, PLDT, okay, Ayala, SM, yung mga yan, they are regularly giving dividends. That means that is passive as well. Kasi two ways of earning from stocks, dividends, and capital appreciation. So, pwede rin yung passive. Then, rentals. Dito na papasok yung real estate properties. Kung meron kang properties na natutulog lang or meron kang extra room sa bahay mo, okay, then you can rent it. That is also passive kasi walang nangyayaring, there is no too much management on your part. Okay? Now, sa mga condominiums or dun sa mga real estate investment. Now, ang nangyayari is sometimes, okay, pag inilagay mo yan sa Airbnb, para sa akin, magiging active income mo rin yan. Okay? If you are doing it, you are posting it, and you need to meet the everyday, kailangan mo magpunta doon, linisin yung house, linisin yung pinapaupahan every month, no? Then that is not passive. That is getting active. Okay? So, pwede rin namang sa mga property rentals, kailangan mo ng broker. So that means ang broker na ang bahala sa investment mo, you will just receive rental payment monthly. Kung ikaw ay nasa rental business, okay, ng property, much better you ask for longer period or contract pagkatapos ask them to issue checks already. Then tell them na sila na ang bahala sa maintenance, bahala na sila sa lahat ng pangangailangan ng property mo. Then that is 100% passive income. Okay? So, anong kailangan natin gawin? You need to study first. Those that are mentioned under passive income, I have personal experience from it. But then, you really need to choose. Sa mutual funds, okay, balikan ko lang ng konti, there are so many companies na nag-o-offer nito. Okay, pwedeng kunin mo balance funds, okay, growth funds. Depende sa risk appetite or objective mo. Investment objective and time horizon. So you need always to check kung saan ka nababagay. Okay, let's move on. Rental properties na mention ko and dividends for the part of passive income. So this is my example. Okay, I have a property before. So I have a guest, so I publish it. Okay, like what I have said, dapat, oh, pwede rin namang passive yan if someone is managing it for you. You are giving a commission and then you just receive the money. Especially for those Filipinos abroad. Kasi nasa abroad ka, so you want somebody to manage it. Okay? Then, dividends. Ito yung example ng dividends. Okay? This transaction was year 2017 pa. I wasn't able to update this part. But again, these are sample of the passive income. So, dividends here, if you invest on the stocks, you will receive a cash dividend. Then, it is passive. So, both passive, this one, 2,223. Pesos. Okay? Now, I usually do finance transformation. Okay? This is one reason why I keep sharing. Okay? Ako po is trader in the stock market. So, this is not passive. Pero, kung ikaw ay marunong mag-invest, then you can really grow your money through the stock market. Again, there is a difference between investing and trading. What I want to show you is just a sample of how I did my transformation through the stock market. Okay, this time I did it through trading. Okay, so meaning this is an active income. Look here, the value is 398,386. Okay, this is my funds. Okay, ito yung mga companies that I bought. Ang total equity ko is 398,621. Actually, this was year 2012, okay, if I'm not mistaken because I did not update this one. But this is 2012 and then 2013, okay, this is, see here, October actually, okay, and then this is January na, okay. Now, ang amount na dito ng equity ko is, sorry, I did not able to capture. Hindi ko pwedeng ipakita yung stocks na yon. So from 398,000 pesos into 1 million pesos. Yung 398,386 was turned into 1 million pesos. So yan po yung ginawa nating finance transformation in the stock market before. Again, this one is risky and I'm not recommending it yet unless you have done the steps-by-step process in the financial freedom ladder. I only invest the money which is extra and then I grow it. So yan po yung ginawa kong finance transformation. Now, then the next step will be building wealth. Okay, this is accumulating good assets. Dito na po tayo sa accumulation ng good assets. Okay, anong ibig sabihin naman ito? Okay, so nandun tayo sa building passive income, sinama ko yung rental properties doon. Dito sa accumulating good assets, I include here all other pension funds, investment opportunities, startup businesses, and other financial opportunities. And skills. I considered skills as a good assets as well. Kasi very famous right now are the freelancing. Okay, if you heard about it, maraming social media manager, copywriter, online business, e-commerce, dropshipping, okay, Amazon, Lazada, Shopee, virtual assistant. So most of this, you are building skills. So ito na yung time that you accumulate good assets that will give you return in the future. Of course, kasama dito sinama ko na actually yung pension funds. So it's up to you kung saan pension funds ka maglalagay. Okay? Then investment opportunities, no, na pwedeng dumating sa'yo. Lalo na right now, I think there is already a crowdfunding opportunities. You can do as well cooperatives, startup business. You can do your own startup business. And then any other financial opportunities. Okay? Dito sa good assets, isama rin natin dito kasi na-mention ko na yung real estate sa building passive income. Kung tama yung ginawa mo, magiging passive siya, like what I have said, somebody manage it for you. Now, dito, kasama pa rin naman ang real estate. Okay? But again, you need to find a good location. You need to have a really good asset or good real estate property na pwede mong mapaupahan. Now, do your own research. Okay? So this is what I'm doing on my side. Okay? Of course, I'm setting up businesses on the side actually. So I'm thinking this year, okay, Of course, I'm growing up a blog. Okay, blog is part of it. I considered my blog as a business. This is an online school, which is I'm trying to do. Right now, I'm building audiences, which is the CPA dreams for CPA aspirants. On the other hand, before, okay, and right now, okay, we are running an online review, which is the CPARMY as well. Okay, these are considered setting up your own business. Okay, so since my partner naman ako dyan, siya lahat ang gumagawa. Okay, but then this year, I'm planning to have, okay, so this is one of the business that I'm thinking to do. Okay, which is jewelry business. Okay, an online jewelry shop. Okay, I'm trying to look at the jewelry. Okay, with the help of my wife. So I'm studying it right now. Tinitingnan ko, pinag-aaralan. Since the industry that I'm with is somewhat related to this business. Okay? So do your own startup business. Pwede yung online, pwede yung e-commerce. Kahit nga mag-start ka lang ng FB page. Like for example, no, my wife, when we are in Abu Dhabi, she started doing cheesecake. Okay, but now since we move in Dubai, she is not doing it. But I asked her to share with me for jewelry shop. Okay, online jewelry. Okay, but we are starting small. Okay, so that is one. Okay, blog is also part of setting up your own business. Kasi ang daming pwedeng sources of income in the blogging. Okay, sa blogging, pwedeng views, pwedeng ads, pwedeng sponsorship, speaking engagement. There are so many things on the blogging area. Okay, so I want you to check all of them. Okay, later, I will have also a session regarding starting a business on the side. Okay, now, let's move on. So then, after all of the steps, then you will have the financial freedom. Okay? Ito na yung everything is working well. Okay? Everything is in place. You have your own business. You have your security with your retirement funds. You already have your investments. Okay? You don't have any financial worries. And you are consistently giving back. Anong ibig sabihin? Ikaw ay tumutulong na sa paligid, okay? Or sa community mo. Sorry, excuse me. Ito na yung wala ka ng financial worries, okay? And actually, this is related. Actually, there is a higher ladder, which is the abundance part, okay? Credit to my coach, which is J. Tripatino, for the financial abundance. This, so hanggang dun tayo sa financial freedom ladder, which is we need to achieve. And then the abundance part is where you give to the community. Okay? Pwede ka na magbigay. Hindi ka na tumitingin. Pagka kumakain ka sa restaurant, you are not looking at the right side of the menu. Okay? Ang tinitingnan mo, okay, beefsteak. I want a beefsteak. I want this food. Okay? Hindi ka na tumitingin. Wala ka ng worries. Nakakapunta ka sa mga gusto mong shows without thinking about the price of the ticket. Ito rin yung time na may lalapit sa'yo na family member, I need a sponsorship for my schooling. Okay? Kasi last semester na, meron akong problem sa finances, I need to pay the tuition fee and you are able to help. Ito na yung time na meron kang scholarship na pinamimigay. Ito na rin yung time na uuwi ka ng Pilipinas. Even if you are not going to work, money is going to come from your account. Okay? Ito na yung tinatawag na financially free. Remember the 100 million pesos that I'm giving you? That is the time that you already achieved your 100 million pesos. Again, literally, that is not the amount that I'm saying. Kasi iba't iba po ang lifestyle natin. So magkakaiba ang financial pocket natin. So nasa sa'yo yun kung papaano mo ikakalculate yung financial freedom amount mo. Okay? But again, I want you to think without restrictions. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng yon is kaya mong i-achieve. Okay? And then, of course, if you are an OFW, then focus on it. Focus on the financial freedom. This is no financial worries, living from your passive income. You can travel the world. You can spend time with your loved ones without any restriction, doing what you love, what you really love. You are not stuck in the 9 to 5 hours of your job that you are not happy. Hindi ka masaya sa ginagawa mo. So, meaning, you are free to do anything and everything in life. Okay? And of course, this is through God's help then. Okay? Because I believe you, everyone is destined to be financially free. Okay? So, yun po yun. Okay? I-review lang natin. Okay? So, please comment if you can remember. Okay? If you can remember those steps. Okay? I just need to take water. Wait lang. Okay, so remember it. Please comment what are those financial freedom ladder. So, i-review natin. Again, eliminating liabilities, saving for your emergency funds, start protecting yourself, building passive income, accumulating good assets, then financial freedom. So, yun po yung session natin. So, again, do your own self-awareness check. Okay? Pakigawa lang po nun. Okay? I'm sharing this. I'm doing this. Kasi I believe that if Filipinos are financially free, we will never have any problems. No? Yung COVID-19 vaccine is already available in so many countries. Can you imagine if the Philippines will have it later? So then the number of cases will keep going up. Okay, it will goes up and goes up and goes up. But then if the country have the money, then even if the vaccine will not be free, everyone can afford it. So sana dumating tayo dun sa time na we will not have any financial worries. Okay? And of course, I want to leave you scripture, which is my favorite, Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Okay? So, in the next coming months, accumulating good assets actually. Okay? So, investing in the stock market, nilagay ko po yan dito. Okay? Doon tayo sa investing, which is part of building passive income and accumulating good assets. Okay? Ibig sabihin, mag-i-invest naman tayo. So, sa upcoming month ng February, I'm going to share about investing in the stock market. And pakiabangan, this coming week then sa Saturday, I have a special guest. Okay? I will not disclose it yet. But then again, it will be about personal finance. And then the next month in February, I will teach you how to invest in the stock market. Okay? So yun po yung focus ko. Okay. Now, what I want to ask is, of course, please like PAM Academy. Why PAM? Planning, Actions, and Mindset Academy. It is free. Most of the lessons that I'm sharing are free. And this is my mission, which is spread the entrepreneurial spirit to help Filipinos achieve their dreams and aspirations in life. So whatever dreams you have, I believe kasi na everyone deserves to achieve their dreams. Everyone have aspirations na maging financially free, maging maayos ang pamilya, maging maayos ang pamilya, maging maayos ang bukas. So this is one reason I keep sharing. Even if one or two Filipinos will hear me with my message, I will be more than happy. Kaya maraming salamat if you are here and if you are listening into this session. Again, Jonathan Ruiz po, maraming salamat. Now, let's have a question and answer. Okay, so if you have a question, please leave your comment below or message me. While if you are on the Zoom, please message and then I will answer it. So in 5 minutes, okay, so we'll have a 5-minute session of Q&A. Okay, so please message me or comment. Okay, so 5 minutes. So while I'm waiting for your question, let me just get water. Okay, I will stop sharing now.